हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस डे 30। लेट अस रिकैप्चुलेट द लास्ट सेशन। यस, इन लास्ट सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कार्डियक आउटपुट, हाउ मच वैल्यूम ऑफ ब्लड दैट पंप्स द हार्ट इनटू ब्लड वेसल इन ए मिनट। So about that we concluded in last class, that is cardiac output, and as well as pulse and blood pressure. What is pulse and blood pressure, how it measure blood pressure, so high BP, low BP, low tension, hypertension, hypotension, about that we discussed. And next, about double circulation, our heart exhibit double circulation. It pumps the blood in two circuits, namely systemic circuit circulation and second one pulmonary circuit circulation, right? So these two things in detail we learned with the visual representation in last session. Once again I am going to show the visual represents the systemic circulation. You observe here the systemic circulation extended between heart and as well as body parts. Follow? The systemic circulation extended between heart and body parts. So it starts from left ventricle and ends in right atria. So you observe this visual representation, body parts these are, and lungs. Now started systemic circulation from left ventricle to body parts through aorta. Next, from body parts to again right atria. This is the path of systemic circulation. Let us see the second variant of circulation, that is pulmonary circuit circulation. In the pulmonary circuit circulation, what is pulmonary circuit circulation? The circulation that extended between heart and lungs. So it occurs between heart and lungs. You observe, this is lung. So this pulmonary circuit circulation extended from which chamber of heart? It extended from right ventricle. Only deoxygenated blood received into right ventricle. So it starts from right ventricle. Next, you observe, so from right ventricle to pulmonary aorta to the blood reaches delivered into lungs. After purification it get oxygenated blood, then it drain into left atria. So the pulmonary circuit circulation extended between what chambers? Right ventricle and left atria. So all these things we discussed in last session. Today we are going to discuss the circulation through significant regions. So if we observe our blood vascular system, in our blood vascular system, arterial system is there, venous system is there. Besides that, some accessory pathways also present to circulate the blood to that regions and as well as collect the blood from that regions. So today we are going to discuss circulation through significant regions. What are they? For that purpose, you observe, they are coronary circulation is present, one. And second one, hepatic portal circulation, and third one, hypofacial portal circulation. So these three are different, peculiar. So let us see what is coronary circulation. Coronary circulation is nothing but the circulation of blood to the wall of heart. So the supply of oxygenated blood to the heart musculature and collecting deoxygenated blood from the heart musculature called what? Coronary circulation. That is coronary circulation. So in this phenomena, what happens? The oxygenated blood delivered to the heart musculature, myocardium, and as well as deoxygenated blood return into the heart chambers. So that phenomena is called coronary circulation. Follow? So in the coronary circulation, what vessels to be involved? Let us see. Already I taught about these vessels, coronary arteries and coronary vein. You observe, on the surface of the heart, coronary arteries are present, which supplies oxygenated blood to cardiac musculature, left anterior coronary artery and right coronary artery. You observe, they arise from base of aorta and supplies oxygenated blood to cardiac musculature. In the same manner, the deoxygenated blood going to collected by coronary veins. Alright? These coronary veins open into coronary sinus that open into right atria. Alright? So in coronary circulation, what are going to involve? Coronary arteries and coronary veins. Coronary artery supplies oxygenated blood to cardiac musculature. Coronary veins collects deoxygenated blood from cardiac musculature. Alright? So that is about coronary circulation, right? You observe, this is coronary artery supplies pure blood and coronary veins collects deoxygenated blood. Alright? Right. Hepatic portal circulation. So in our blood vascular system, besides arteries and veins, portal veins are present. Let us know what is portal vein. What is portal vein? The portal veins nothing but some of the veins that starts with capillary from a organ and ends in another organ with capillary network other than the heart called portal vein. Generally, where artery ends, from there vein starts with capillary network, and vein ultimately ends in heart. But here what happens? Some of the veins starts from an organ with capillary network and ends in another organ, not in heart, ends in another organ with capillary network. So the blood drain between these two organs other than the heart. Followed? So such kind of veins considered as portal veins. That portal veins forms portal circulation. Such portal veins connected with what organ? Based on name of the organ, the portal circulation diversified. Hepatic means what? Liver. Suppose the portal vein ends in liver, that is called hepatic portal circulatory system. Suppose the portal vein if end in kidney, that consider as what? Renal portal circulation. Of course, the renal portal circulation is a primitive found only in lower vertebrates, fishes, amphibians and reptiles. In AFC it is reduced, in mammals completely absent renal portal system. But in all vertebrates, in all chordates, the hepatic portal circulation is predominant, well developed. So let us see in human being how the hepatic portal circulatory system executed. You observe this is hepatic portal system. You observe the network, capillary network. So this is capillary network of a vein extending from stomach and going to end in liver. That is a hepatic portal circulation. Right? One more capillary network. And going to end in kidney. Renal portal circulation. So generally the portal circulations are two kinds. One is hepatic portal circulation and second one renal portal circulation. We are going to discuss about hepatic portal circulation. So the human being hepatic portal circulatory system comprises four veins. It comprises four veins, namely, remember students, very very important, four veins collectively forms human hepatic portal system. They are superior mesenteric vein and second one splenic vein, third one gastric vein and cystic vein. So three veins forms hepatic portal vein. What are they? Superior mesenteric vein, splenic vein, gastric vein and cystic vein. Right. Next, you observe this is our hepatic portal circulation. You verify all these four vein along with hepatic portal vein. So first, superior mesenteric vein. So it starts with capillary network. The superior mesenteric vein collects blood from stomach, wall of stomach and small intestine and some parts of large intestine also. Okay. Next, the second vein is splenic vein. You observe this is splenic vein. The splenic vein collects the blood from stomach as well as spleen and some part pancreas also. So and ultimately joined with the hepatic portal vein. Next, third one, gastric vein collects blood from stomach, and fourth one, cystic vein. So all these four veins merges together and ultimately forms what? Hepatic portal vein. So that hepatic portal vein enter into, you observe, this is hepatic portal vein, enter into liver and ends with capillary network. Okay. From that capillary network, you observe, you verify the blue color capillary network going to extend that consent to hepatic vein that open into inferior vena cava behind the liver. In the visual you observe blue color long tube is present, that is inferior vena cava. So the hepatic portal vein drains blood ultimately into hepatic vein and again the hepatic vein drains blood into inferior vena cava that reaches the right atrium of our heart. That is the circulation path. Right. So you observe this is hepatic vein. Ultimately the blood drain into hepatic vein from hepatic portal vein. Right. This is hepatic portal circulation. Next, what is significance of hepatic circulation? What is importance? Let us see. It achieves what functions? So the hepatic portal circulatory system mainly meant for collection of digested food material and nutrients from the intestine and from parts of our gut. So it collects various kinds of nutrients and digested food material from the stomach and as well as intestine. Okay, so it is specially meant for, very very important, it is specially meant for collecting nutrients from alimentary canal. And next, it collects proteins that produced in liver and supplied to all over the body. Follow? So the prepared proteins in the liver, the synthesized proteins in the liver, so relieved into the blood of hepatic portal vein, and ultimately through the circulation they deliver to all parts of our body, right? And as well as along the food material, we consume the toxic material, we consume the microorganisms. So such microorganism, toxic material from our gut first enter into liver through this hepatic portal circulation, and such things to be detoxified, microorganisms to be killed by phagocytosis phenomena through Kupffer cells. So the toxic material also detoxified. So the detoxification possible due to the presence of this hepatic portal circulation. Right? These are the major significant features of hepatic portal circulation. Let us see one more special circulation method that formed in human being circulatory system. That is the hypophyseal portal circulation. What is hypophyses? Pituitary gland, the anterior lobe. So the pituitary gland, anterior lobe considered as hypophyses. So let us see hypophyseal portal circulation. So this is pituitary gland, endocrine gland, situated floor of the diencephalon. Hands downwards with a stalk that is called infundibulum. You verify a capillary network is present. So the floor of the diencephalon is called hypothalamus. The hypophyseal portal vein extended between hypothalamus and anterior lobe of pituitary gland. All right? So you verify the visible. This is hypothalamus, the floor of diencephalon. Diencephalon is a part of our brain. So this is hypothalamus, and next this is anterior lobe of pituitary. In between these two you verify capillary network, and vessels are extended. Vessel is extended. So that is a hypophyseal portal circulation. So this is inflow of the vessel and outflow of the vessel. Follow? This is hypophyseal portal vein. Follow? Let us see regulation of cardiac activity. With this we finished special circulation to special regions, coronary circulation completed, hepatic portal circulation, and hypophyseal portal circulation completed. Let us see regulation of cardiac activity, heart activity. So already we discussed normal heart rate in a healthy person in resting condition. In adults, the heart shows heart beats how many, 72 times per minute. That is a normal heartbeat rate. So generally the autorhythmicity of such heart generally extend in normal condition, but always the same heart rate never maintained. For example, the person doing exercise, at that time the oxygen demand is there, so automatically our breathing rate increases. If breathing rate increases to supply oxygen, the circulation rate also must be increased. For that purpose, the pumping rate also must increase. So automatically, the heartbeat rate raises in this condition. During exercise, you observe, when we are in danger, when we are in fear, when we are suffering with fever, at that time, so when we are in tension, at that time, generally our heartbeat rate raises. Of course, in resting condition, it is 72 times per minute. But in some special conditions, special situations, the heartbeat rate may increases or decreases. Such increase and decrease according to our requirement, regulated by a specialized systems. Alright, so let us see in what way the cardiac activity to be regulated. Alright, the regulation of cardiac activity mediated by various methods. For that purpose, in our body, autoregulation mechanism is present. The autoregulation mechanism by nodal tissue. Already we discussed, the nodal tissue regulates the autorhythmicity. Our heart is myogenic heart. Normally, the regular heart rate, autorhythmicity of regular heart rate mediated by nodal tissue that include sinoatrial node, atrioventricular node, bundle of His, Purkinje fibers, they propagate the action potential all over the wall of heart and initiates the heartbeat and exhibits the autorhythmic contraction. So the autoregulation of cardiac rhythmicity mediated by nodal tissue. Followed? And second one, neural regulation is present. The neural regulation by medulla oblongata. In our brain, the medulla oblongata is one of the part. So that medulla oblongata controls and coordinates the activity of heart rate by sending the signals to the wall of heart by means of nerve fibers. The nerve fibers are what? Normal cranial nerve fibers, for example, vagus nerve is there, 10th cranial nerve. So through the vagus nerve send signals, and as well as besides that, sympathetic and parasympathetic network also associated with the medulla oblongata and regulates the heart activity. And third one, chemical regulation. So this is third method. So the cardiac activity mediated by three ways. One is autoregulation, and second one is neural regulation, and third one chemical regulation. Chemical regulation is nothing but by hormones. Follow? Yes, let us see in detail. So first, neural regulation by medulla oblongata. In medulla oblongata, a specialized center meet for it. So that is cardiovascular center. Remember, it's very, very important. The cardiovascular center of medulla oblongata regulates heart activity. Followed? Right. The cardiovascular center, remember one more information. The cardiovascular center of medulla oblongata contain two components. One is cardio inhibitor and another one is cardio accelerator. Remember, students, very, very important. The cardiovascular center of medulla oblongata contain again two components. One is what? Inhibitor. Another one is what? Accelerator. What is the function of cardio inhibitor? The cardio inhibitor slows down the heart function, reduces the heart function. Followed. What about the cardio accelerator? The cardio accelerator raises the activity, heart activity, increases the heart activity. So that is the function of cardio accelerator. So by sending signals through cardio inhibitor center and cardio accelerator center, such feedback mechanism to be mediated. According to these signals, the nodal tissue respond, cardiac musculature to be respond and increases heart activity, either decreases the heart activity. So that is neural regulation by medulla oblongata. How it is possible? Let us see in detail. So the cardiovascular center of medulla oblongata connected with different networks. So they are what? Connected with the sympathetic nerve fibers as well as parasympathetic nerve fibers, as well as sensory receptors that associated with wall of blood vessels. Remember, the cardiovascular center of medulla oblongata connected with different neural networks. What are they? Sympathetic nerve fibers, parasympathetic nerve fibers and sensory receptors, by which they receive the signals and propagate the signals. Sensory receptors sensitizes the situation and send signals to medulla oblongata. Then the medulla oblongata send signals through what? Sympathetic nerve fibers, otherwise parasympathetic nerve fibers. The sympathetic nerve fiber connected with what? Accelerator center. Parasympathetic nerve connected with inhibitor center, and through vagus nerve it extended to the wall of the heart musculature. Let us see this visual. So you observe, this is our brain. Medulla oblongata contain cardiovascular center. That cardiovascular center, through nerve fibers, it connected with cardiac musculature. The nerve fibers are sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve fiber, and as well as the same cardiovascular center also connected with a network of sensory receptors. You observe at the base of aorta and carotid artery, yellow color spots are there. They are sensory receptors through nerve fiber. They connected with the cardiovascular center. So thereby it mediates the cardiac activity. Let us see in what way the heart activity may increased, in what way the heart activity decreased. Let us see by neural regulation. So the sympathetic neural network accelerates the cardiac activity. For example, we require more heart activity doing exercise. We require more heart activity. At that time, the sensory receptors recognizes the situation and send signals to cardiovascular center of medulla oblongata. So such signals are recognized by the accelerator center. Then that signals through cardio accelerator part reaches to the cardiac musculature through sympathetic nerve fibers. These sympathetic nerve fibers automatically increases cardiac activity. So how they increases cardiac activity? They increases heartbeat, and as well as they increases arterial constriction. The muscle layer, whatever present in the wall of arteries. So by the influence of this sympathetic neural network, the wall of artery undergoes contraction, constriction, by which the lumen will become narrow and blood pressure will be increased. Then the blood supply to easily in all tissues in our body. So this is these are the changes that mediated by sympathetic neural network. Follow, student? Right? So the sympathetic neural network accelerates the cardiac activity. So it brought what changes? It increases heartbeat and increases arterial constriction. What about next? The parasympathetic neural system. The parasympathetic neural system extended to cardiac musculature through vagus nerve from the cardiovascular center of the medulla oblongata. So the parasympathetic neural network reduces cardiac activity. It is a negative effect. So first one, positive, and it is negative effect. It reduces the cardiac activity. Whatever signals received from parasympathetic nerve fibers, immediately the response like decreases heartbeat. Heartbeat rate decreases heartbeat. And next, increases dilation of vessels. Remember, increases dilation of vessel. So dilation means stretch. The wall of blood vessel, what happens? Stretches. Then automatically the lumen will become wider. So blood pressure become lower. So the blood pressure to be reduced. Follow? So it reduces blood pressure by what? Increasing dilation of blood vessel. Don't confuse. So whether dilation of blood vessel increases, automatically blood pressure, what happens? Decreases down. Heartbeat rate also going to decrease and blood pressure also going to decrease. So it is what effect? Negative effect. Alright? So the sympathetic neural system mediates positive feedback mechanism and parasympathetic neural system mediates negative feedback mechanism. So thereby these two are regulates the heart activity by feedback mechanism, and for this purpose the sensory receptors are executed with wall of blood vessels. These sensory receptors are baroreceptors. They are associated with wall of carotid artery, which supplies blood to brain, and second one at the base of aortic arc, so which arise from the left ventricle. So in the wall of aortic arc and carotid artery, specialized sensory structures are there. They are baroreceptors. They perceive the signals. They sensitize the signals, oxygen level, whatever it may be, and pressure, everything they recognize. They are baroreceptors. They sensitize blood pressure in the blood vessel and send feedback signals to cardiac center for moderate cardiac activity, by which the heart activity may slow down or may rise. So this is by what? Neural regulation. And regulation of cardiac activity by chemical substances, chemical regulation. The chemical regulation mediated by what? Hormones. So generally two kinds of hormones. The hormones from adrenal gland also plays key role in regulation of cardiac activity, and as well as thyroxine hormone also involves indirectly to mediate the cardiac activity. Let us see. So the adrenal gland, the medulla of adrenal gland secretes two kinds of hormones. They are epinephrine, otherwise called adrenaline hormone, and second one, norepinephrine. called what? Noradrenaline hormone. So adrenaline hormone, noradrenaline hormone. These two hormones favors vasoconstriction. Follow? These two hormones favors what? Vasoconstriction means the blood vessel undergoes constriction. Automatically, blood pressure increases. Follow? So these two hormones favors vasoconstriction. Thereby, blood pressure increases, heartbeat rate increases. But here, you remember, students, in normal condition, the norepinephrine increases heartbeat rate. But in emergency condition, when we are in fear, when we are in tension, when we are in danger, follow? So at that time, adrenaline hormone secreted, fight and flight hormones. So in emergency condition, such changes brought by adrenaline hormone, in normal conditions, it is mediated by noradrenaline hormone. But both are adrenaline hormone and noradrenaline hormone, both are increases heart rate. Besides that, the thyroxine hormone also indirectly participate in regulation of cardiac activity. Thyroxine hormone is a metabolic hormone, raises the metabolic rate, requires the oxygen, oxygen demand establishes. To fulfill the oxygen demand, automatically the heart rate increases. So indirectly, the thyroxine hormone also mediates the regulation of cardiac activity. So with this, we completed regulation of cardiac activity by autoregulation, neural regulation, and chemical regulation. In next session, we are going to learn about blood vessels. What are blood vessels are present, and their properties, differences, everything we will learn. Thank you.